Progress saving or phase saving is a technique that was invented by the developers of the SAT solver RSAT. The idea of progress saving is to store, to memorize, the truth values assigned to a variable and then to reuse this truth value when it comes to deciding upon this variable again. Progress saving is thus a sign heuristics, that is, a heuristics that tells the solver which truth value to assign to a decision variable. To better understand the effect of progress saving, imagine the solver encounters a conflict. It will then start to analyze the conflict in order to identify its origin. Then it will backjump to the origin and go down the search space again. On its way down, progress saving will tell the solver to assign to each decision variable the truth value it has obtained before. As a consequence, progress saving will direct the solver in a search space that is close or at least similar to the one it was before the backjump. The motivation of this strategy is to avoid solving the same subproblem again on the way down into the search space. Generally, the larger the backjumps, the better this strategy works. However, for optimization, it has a particular effect because it directs the solver back into a similar or closely related search space, hence it elaborates more on local optima. Let us explore this from the experimental side. To begin with, let us look at CLASP's option for progress saving. We look in our helper file. Here it is. So it is called save progress, and given the decisive role of the backjump length, it takes this length as a parameter to kick in progress saving or not. So depending on whether your backjump is larger than the given number, then progress saving will be taken to do the sign heuristics, otherwise the system's default will be used. Okay, now let's start and run some examples. And let's do so by launching CLASP on our prepared traveling salesperson problem. And to begin with, let's switch progress saving off. This is done by giving it the option 0. So if we do so, we see it takes us 13 models to converge to the optimum. Now let's do the same, but switch progress saving on after each back jump greater than 1. That is more or less always. Okay, if we do so, we already see that it takes us 5 more models to reach the optimum because the solver stays more often in the local neighborhood of the last optimum. Now, let's make a compromise. Let's say we do progress saving after each backjump of length 10. And here we get an intermediate convergence number, that is, we only get 15 models. So you see that progress saving has quite an impact, and we can actually make this even clearer by looking at another example. For this, I was playing a little bit with the traveling salesperson problem, and you may recall that actually the traveling salesperson problem without the optimization statement amounts to the Hamiltonian cycle problem. Now, this is then this problem. I just removed the optimization statement, but then I thought, well, why don't we turn this problem into an optimization problem? That is, we have here this imperative integrity constraint that says all nodes must be reachable, but why not put this into an optimization function and let CLASP optimize it? So the result of this is this program here. So it's exactly the same as before, just that I replaced the integrity constraint with an optimization statement. And in this way, we can observe actually how many nodes are reachable in each model. Okay, so for this, we launch these commands here. Let's go back to the shell. So our objective function minimizes the number of unreachable nodes. Hence, the best and optimum value to obtain is 0. This indicates all nodes are reachable. Okay, let's first do this with progress saving turned on, that is, we'll be revisiting similar search spaces on the way when converging. And as we see here, we use 25 models to converge to the optimum. At first we find a model with 56 unreachable nodes, then 44, and this goes down to 0 unreachable nodes. Okay, now let's switch progress saving off. And as we see, we converge much better to the optimum. Instead of taking 25 models to find the optimum model, it only takes us 11 to find it. This shows us that it appears to be better to redirect the solver after each successful finding of a model into another part of the search space. In fact, we can do this with Clasp, and there's an option which is called restart on model. That is, whenever a model is found, Clasp goes back to the very beginning, takes of course his heuristics values, its learned information, and restarts. And the idea is of course that here you even more drastically go in different parts of the search space because you undo the choices that are before the back jump. Okay, let's do that. And as we see, this has even a more drastic effect. We converge by enumerating only 4 models to the optimum one. I hope you like this little discussion on progress saving, even though progress saving appears to be not the best choice for accelerating the convergence. But we have seen actually how important it is to shake up the search after a model was found. That is, find a model, shake it up, and then look for the next model. Okay, so this was the first clip of part 4 on progress saving. Hope you enjoyed it and stay tuned.